Good morning, students. Now I am going to discuss the first module of industrial drives and applications. Under this, I am going to discuss steady state and transient state stability of electrical drive. Okay. So here, using the basics of your motor load combination, we know that equation. The fundamental torque equation we know, that is T minus T1 equal to d by dt j omega m. And here first you are going to this differentiate actually this term, that is dj divided by dt. This term I already said this will be is equal to 0 for drives with a constant inertia. Okay, that value will be is equal to 0 for drives with constant inertia. The inertia should not change. Okay, that's why here we are going to take this equation. For any drives, electrical drives, the inertia should be constant. Okay, well, for any electrical drives, the inertia should be constant. It should not change with respect to time. So that's why this is going to be neglect. So therefore, your motor load, motor torque and load torque will be is equal to, that equation will be, the motor torque is equal to T1 plus J into d omega divided by dt. Now, what is mean by steady state stability? What is mean by steady state stability means, actually, we know that equilibrium state, state of equilibrium of electric drive. Okay. If the, when the electric drive goes to equilibrium state means, when the load torque and motor torque is equal, then it will, electrical drive will goes to equilibrium state. If that state will be changes because of the inductance and inertia, okay, because of inductance and inertia, that is said to be steady state stability. In the same, if there is any sudden and fast changes occurs from the equilibrium state because of inertia and inductance, and that cannot be neglected, then it is said to be transient stability or dynamic stability. Okay, and what are the criteria we have to consider for steady state stability means load torque, motor torque, speed, and also some small deviations. That is, if the del, if you are representing del del, then it is said to be a small change in that particular component. So here the this component will be have multiplied with this del. This del is nothing but small change in motor torque, small change in load torque, small change in speed after the displacement of equilibrium. Okay. When the change of state of the equilibrium state to steady state or transient state, this the small changes also we have to consider. Okay. When the change of state due to displacement, the change of state from that is a small change of state from equilibrium to other state, steady state or transient state, we have to consider all the small deviation. Now with respect to this components TM, TL, omega, del TM, del TL and del omega, I'm going to write the equation. So all the equations I have written here, you see the J into d omega divided by dt, this TL and this TM, we are going to substitute 0, and these small changes values we are separately we are going to substitute to 0. Okay, we are, all this equation will be taken and all should be equal to 0. Okay, and all should be equal to 0 because all these things, this del into TL, del into TM, what I said, because of the displacement from the equilibrium state to other state, like steady state and transient state, so that we are equating this equation equal to 0. So the, and so I'm going to take all the constant components equal to 0 and the small deviation components is also equal to 0. Now considering the small deviation, changes can be expressed as the linear function change in speed. When the deviation, when the displacement occur from the normal state to the small deviation means change in the speed. Okay, change in the speed from the torque equation, when all the quantities are expressed in terms of their deviation from the equilibrium, we can write del into TM is equal to dTM divided by d omega into del omega comma del into TL is equal to dTL divided by d omega into del omega. Okay, now here this equation I'm going to substitute in del tm and del tl. This del omega is common, so it is taken outside, and del tl divided by d omega minus del tm divided by d omega. I said as time increases, the speed should decrease. If it is decreases, then this equation will be is equal to zero, because this small deviation we are going to neglect. So your road torque will be is equal to motor torque. Now this shows the equilibrium state. Now this, when you consider if the initial state, initial speed, deviation in speed, and this value will be multiplied with the negative exponential value. Why we are going to multiply with negative exponential value means as the time increase, the speed should diminish. If the e power minus 1, e power minus 2, minus 3, like that, if you substitute, that value will be diminish. Here we are going to take omega, del omega naught is nothing but your initial value of your deviation in speed, and this value will be multiplied with the negative component. Why this negative component means, in order to show that as the time increase, your speed will be diminish, so that you will get this del d into tl divided by d omega minus d into tm divided by d omega, that is nothing but your equilibrium state shows greater than zero. Now this coming to the final thing, the criteria, the next, what is the criteria for stability, steady state stability means, here for a decrease in speed, the motor torque exceeds. This listen carefully, for the next, what is the next criteria means, as the speed is decrease, okay, the speed decrease in the speed, the motor torque exceeds the load torque. Okay, so if the motor is increasing with more speed means nothing but the motor torque is greater than the load torque. Okay, so speed decreases means what? Your motor torque is greater than the load torque. Okay, next condition is, if your speed is increasing means your motor torque is less than your load torque. Okay, speed is decreasing means your motor torque is less than your load torque. Okay, so this is the another criteria for steady state stability. And what I told, stable equilibrium point means your load torque TL, okay, your load torque, and the load torque TL results in the stable equilibrium point, and the load torque TL double dash results in the unstable situation. Okay, so here the load torque TL is nothing but your load torque, means that your TL, load torque TL results in equilibrium point. Equilibrium point means your load torque and motor torque will be equal. If the load torque is denoted by T into TL double dash, means that your load torque comes to the unstable situation. Okay, your load torque comes to the unstable situations. Okay, so this is about your first module. So thank you students, your first module is over. Okay, thank you students.